So, characteristics of nucleus we are going to discuss. Nucleus having protons and neutrons. So, protons having positive charge, neutrons no charge. Hence, the total nucleus having positive charge. First character, charge of nucleus, that is equal to Ze, because Z protons are there, atomic number is Z, and E is charge of each proton, so charge of the nucleus Ze. Second one, about mass of nucleus, mass of nucleus. That is represented by capital M. So let the mass of each proton MP, mass of each neutron MN, then mass of nucleus is equal to Z number of protons are there, hence ZMP plus number of neutrons A minus Z. Already we discussed number of neutrons, mass number minus atomic number. A minus Z MN. So these are the, this is the mass of the nucleus. Protons mass plus neutrons mass is the mass of the nucleus. Third one, what about size, that means the radius of the nucleus. Nucleus is in a spherical shape and its radius is R, then R is equal to R naught A power 1 by 3. The radius of the nucleus depends on, the radius of the nucleus depends on the mass number. So, R is equal to R naught A power 1 by 3. That is the radius of the nucleus, directly proportional to mass number whole power 1 by 3. So, that is radius of the nucleus, where R naught is the radius of the hydrogen nucleus. Hydrogen nucleus contains only one proton. That is the smallest nucleus radius. And so R naught is the radius of the hydrogen nucleus. What about R naught value means 1.2 into 10 power minus 15 meter. That means 1.2 Fermi. That is radius of the hydrogen nucleus. Then the any other nuclei radius R is equal to R naught A power 1 by 3. Okay. Next, what about density of nucleus? Density means mass by volume. How to get mass? Already we got the mass. Volume, it is a spherical shape. 4 by 3 pi R cube. So M by, because sphere volume 4 by 3 pi R cube. So we know the radius R, and substituting the values here, we get approximately 10 power 17 kg per meter cube. That is radius of any nucleus 10 power 17 kg per meter cube. So radius of the nucleus is in the order of 10 power 17 kg per meter cube for any nucleus. Even though hydrogen nucleus or uranium nucleus, density is constant, 10 power 17 kg per meter cube. You know density of water, 10 power 3. It is 10 power 17. That means 10 power 14 times denser than the density of water. Nucleus density is very, very high. 10 power 17 kg per meter cube. That means 10 power 14 times that of the density of the water. You know water density? 1000 kg per meter cube. So water we know. So for that, 10 power 14 times denser the density of the nucleus. Okay. So these are the characteristics of the nucleus. Charge of the nucleus, mass of the nucleus, radius of the nucleus, and density of the nucleus. Okay. Next, some more characters we can discuss. That is a Nuclear forces. Inside nucleus, protons, neutrons are there. There are four type of forces inside the nucleus. One is a strong attractive force, force of attraction. First one, force of attraction. And this attractive force is independent of charge. That means proton-proton attract. Actually, proton-proton positive charges, they can repel. But first there is attractive force between the nucleons. So, FPP, proton-proton attractive force. FNP, neutron-proton also attract. It is independent of charge. Third one, FNN, neutron-neutron attractive force. So, protons, protons attract, proton, neutrons attract, neutron, neutrons also attract. So, all these three forces are equal in magnitude also. So, nuclear force of attraction is independent of the charge. Nuclear force of attraction is independent of charge. Second one, Coulomb repulsive force. Because of positive charge, Coulomb repulsive force. Second one, Coulomb repulsive force. And this repulsive force depends on the charge. So protons only can repel. But it is a weak force, lighter force. But attractive force is a stronger one. Third one, tensor force. Actually, nucleons, spherical in shape. Nucleons means both protons and neutrons are called nucleons. They are spinning around their own axis. Because of that spin, they can act as a magnet. And each nucleon can attract another one. Each nucleon can attract another nucleon because of magnetic nature. So, that force is called tensor force. And fourth one, hardcore repulsive force. Nucleons are attracting and come closer. So, volume become very less. Then, if the nucleons are very closer, less than certain distance, then immediately they can repel. Because of that repulsive force only, the nucleus having finite size. Otherwise, because of strong attractive force, they can crush and entire the nucleus can be destroyed. But when they come closer, the distance is less than 0.5 Fermi, 0.5 into 10 power minus 15 meter, they can repel one another. That is called hardcore repulsive force. Because of this hardcore repulsive force, only nucleus having finite size. These four forces are called nuclear forces. One is the force of attraction, that is independent of the charge. Second one, Coulomb repulsive force. Third one, tensor force, that is due to spin of the nucleons. Fourth one, hardcore repulsive force. Because of this force only, nucleus having finite size, certain volume. And the distance between nucleons is less than 0.5 Fermi, they can repel one another. Okay, so these are the nuclear forces. These are having some characteristics. They are the non-central forces. They are not acting towards the center of the nucleus. Just two nucleons can attract one another. Nuclear forces are non-central forces. Second one, nuclear forces are short-range forces. When the distance is less, there is a force between them. Suppose the nucleons are very far, there is no force. Nuclear forces are short-range forces. Nuclear forces are non-central forces. Okay? So, and a very strong nuclear forces are strong in nature. That means in the nature we have four type of forces. One is gravitational force. Second one, electrostatic force. That means positive negative charges attract, or positive negative charge, I mean positive positive charges repel. The force between two charges is called electrostatic force. Second one, magnetic force. Two magnets are there, north pole can repel, north pole, south pole are there attract. So magnetic forces and nuclear forces. So total four type of forces we have: nuclear force, electrostatic force, magnetic force and gravitational force. Any two masses separated by some distance attract in the universe. That is very very important concept. That's why planets revolving around the sun and moon revolving around the earth, etc. So gravitational force is there in the universe. But compared to all these forces, nuclear forces are strongest forces and gravitational forces are weakest force. Nuclear forces are strongest one, gravitational forces are weakest one. Okay, so these are the characteristics of the nuclear forces. And how to measure the mass of the nucleons? How to measure the mass of the nucleons? Actually, we need the unit. Suppose you want to measure your mass, 1 kg is unit, then 50 times of that one, your mass is 50 kg, your weight is 50 into g, because weight means mg. So mg newtons, your weight is different, mass is different. Like that, you want to measure the length, we have 1 meter rod, then 10 times of that one, 10 meter or 1 feet is there. Your height is 5.5 feet, 6 feet, 7 feet. So 1 feet is 1 unit. Like that, to measure the lighter masses, that means the nucleons masses, we have 1 atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. It is defined as any unit we have to define early. What is 1 kg? 1 kg is the mass of the platinum, iridium, alloy kept in the Sarus Museum in the Paris. The Paris, France, capital Paris, there one museum is there known as Sarus Museum. In that one platinum iridium stone is there. That stone mass taken as 1 kg. Why means nothing? We have to take certain value. That's why that is chosen. Everyone accepted. That is 1 kg. 5 times of that, 5 kg. 10 times of that, 10 kg. Like that we can measure mass. Like that here atomic mass unit, 1 AMU. We call it as AMU. It is 1/12 mass of carbon atom. 1/12 mass of carbon atom is called 1 AMU. Its value 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 kg. 1 AMU value how much? 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 kg. 1 AMU. Then proton mass. Mass of proton how much? In terms of AMU we can express. So 1.0083 U, we can write U. U means AMU only. U means AMU. Like that proton mass, neutron mass, electron mass, we can express in terms of U. U means AMU. Exact values you check in the textbook. In exams, they can give the values of mass of proton, mass of electron in terms of AMU, they can provide. Okay? So, this is about atomic mass unit. Okay. Next one important topic is Einstein mass energy relation. We know very well from lower classes onwards, Einstein formula E is equal to mc square. In Bangalore, in Marthahalli, one big shopping complex is there, big building is there. Its name they kept E is equal to mc square. So that formula, very familiar formula. You also should learn very familiar formulas. and is E is equal to mc square, F is equal to me, mv, V is equal to n lambda, C is equal to nu lambda, E is equal to h nu. These are common basic general formulas, not only science students, everyone should learn. So like that, Einstein mass energy relation E is equal to mc square. What is m? M is mass annihilated, that means destroyed. When mass destroyed, energy can be released. M mass is annihilated, that means suppose this is a body, if you make it into powder, it is not destroyed. Powder should not be there, that thing will be available there, then it is only said to be destroyed. So mass annihilated, so that means all bodies are unable to destroy. But uranium, you can make into inhalation, you can destroy it. Then large quantity of energy will come. How much energy will come? Einstein proposed this formula, E is equal to mc square. Einstein mass energy relation. Suppose 1 kg mass destroyed. How much energy will come? E is equal to 1 into 3 into 10 power 8 whole square. That is 9 into 10 power 16 joules. 9 into 10 power 16 joules energy will come for 1 kg mass destroyed. Suppose 1 gram mass annihilated, destroyed, how much energy will come? E is equal to 1 into 10 power minus 3, 9 into 10 power 16, that is 9 into 10 power 13 joules will come. And we measure the energy in electron volts also. We know 1 electron volt is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 joules. Now what we required is how much energy will come if 1 AMU energy, 1 AMU mass is annihilated or destroyed. 1 AMU destroyed, equivalent energy of 1 AMU how much? E is equal to mc square, that is 1 AMU, M is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 kg. So 1.6 into 10 power minus 27 into 9 into C square, 9 into 10 power 16 joule. That is equal to 1.6 into 10 power minus 27, 9 into 10 power 16 divided by 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 electron volts. We are converting the final energy in electron volts, dividing with 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Then finally we got 931 into 10 power 6 electron volts. That means 931 million electron volts, because 10 power 6 is called million. Therefore, how much mass is destroyed? 1 AMU mass. Therefore, 1 AMU equivalent energy. 1 AMU equivalent energy is equal to 931 MeV. 1 AMU equivalent energy equal to 931 million electron volts. Okay? So, that is very, very important point. So, up to now, first part of nucleus chapter completed. The chapter, entire chapter, we are making into total three parts. One is characteristics of the nucleus, and what about atomic mass number, Einstein mass energy relation, nuclear forces, etc. First part not completed. Some more points we have to discuss. 1 AMU is 931 MeV. Next, we have to see about mass defect. Mass defect. Actually, nucleus contains protons, neutrons. We know the number of protons, number of neutrons. So, mass of each proton we know, mass of each neutron also we know. So we calculated total mass of the nucleons, whatever the inside. So we got certain value. Entire nucleus is measured one time. we got a different value. Why there is a difference? Five members are in the lift. Individually we measured one person weight, certain mass came. Entire five members at a time we measured, some difference came. Why the difference came like that? Here some difference came because some mass inside the nucleus converting into energy to bound the nucleons inside. Inside nucleons are bounded, they are not coming out, they are bounded. We are bounded by the earth, we are unable to escape from the earth. If large velocity is there, then only we can escape. We are always pulling by earth. Even though if you try to jump, you can just to a certain height only, you can jump and you can fall down because of gravitational force. You are bounded by the earth. Like that, nucleons are bounded inside the nucleus. Then, some energy required to bound. From where we got that energy? Some mass of the nucleons converted into energy. That's why we are getting different difference in mass of the nucleons and mass of the nucleus. Mass of nucleons and mass of nucleus is different. Mass defect is the difference of mass of nucleons and mass of the nucleus. Entire nucleus mass is capital M. Mass of nucleons mass we know. The difference is called mass defect, that is represented by delta M. Mass defect delta M is equal to ZMP plus A minus ZMN whole bracket minus capital M. This is a mass defect. Mass of the nucleons minus mass of the nucleus is called mass defect. When the difference is there means that mass is converted into energy to bound the nucleons. And the next one more topic is point is packing fraction. Packing fraction means the mass defect per each nucleon, mass defect delta M by total number of nucleons A. Delta M by A is called packing fraction. The mass defect per each nucleon is called packing fraction. The mass defect per each nucleon is called packing fraction. Okay. Next, binding energy. Binding energy. The energy utilized to bound the nucleons inside the nucleus is called binding energy. Binding energy from where we got the mass defect converted into energy. So delta M, that is mass difference, and that is converted into energy according to Einstein, delta M into C square. This is the binding energy. Okay, next, many nucleons are there. How much energy per each nucleon is there? That is called average binding energy. Average binding energy. The binding energy per each nucleon is called average binding energy. That means binding energy divided by mass number is called average binding energy. Okay? So, mass defect, packing fraction, binding energy, and average binding energy. These are the new terms we got. Before that, atomic mass unit and Einstein mass energy relation we have. Before that, characteristics of the nucleus and nuclear forces already we learned. Okay, now we can check the average binding energy and mass number relation. That means when graph we are plotting by taking average binding energy on y-axis and mass numbers on x-axis. So the average binding, as mass number is increasing, average binding energy first increases, then reaches to the maximum value, then decreases. Average binding energy is maximum for iron, Fe, ferrous. For iron, average binding energy maximum. 8.8 million electron volts. And that means mass number is less, average binding energy is less. Mass number is more, very high, again average binding energy is less. So based on that nuclear fission, heavy nucleus can be split into smaller nuclei that happen when average binding energy is less. Average binding energy is very high, it is very difficult to split the nucleus. Okay, so here average binding energy is less for uranium. That's why we can take uranium, radioactive elements, thorium, etc. They have less average binding energy. Okay, average binding energy is maximum for iron. Okay, so up to this first part of the nucleus. What are in second part? Discovery of neutron, nuclear fission, nuclear fusion, about nuclear reactor, and elementary particles. These are the second part. And the third part is radioactivity. Already we know X-rays, mean alpha, beta, gamma rays, we know not X-rays, alpha rays, beta rays, gamma rays. So those are the called radioactive radiations. We have to discuss that topic separately. So total three parts, nuclear physics, we made three parts. Okay, right, second part we can start.